Welcome to Chamber Showcase. I'm Lisa O'Loughlin, host of the show, and it gives me a great privilege to be able to bring you another episode of what's happening in and around the city of Walden, and especially with the Chamber of Commerce. I'd like to start by welcoming five new members to our chamber. Digitus Fingerprints, Disability Policy Consortium, Fly by the Moon Media, that's kind of a catchy name, Tupperware with Pizzazz, and Grace Julian Murphy. So welcome to Chamber, we're here for you. Be sure to give us a call, let us know what we can do to help you get established in Walden. I'd also like to thank our renewing members. We had 30 renew this past month. I'm not going to give you all their names, but you know who you are. So thanks for renewing your membership. Our biggest upcoming event is happening this month, April 29th. It's the Taste of Walden. As you've heard me say in the past previous two shows, it's my favorite event of the year for the Chamber, where we have about 18 to 22 restaurants and other vendors come to the Walden YMCA. And for one flat rate, you can come in and eat as much as you want from any of or all of them, including wine tasting, vodka tasting, cash bar for soft drinks and water. And we have a raffle for 52 weeks of dining. So there's a lot going on there. By the time you see this show, we'll be just about there. But feel free to call for tickets at the website, the Chamber website, and or you can do PayPal as well. So we're hoping to see you there. The next upcoming event is actually that same week. We have our first restaurant week. It's our 10th Taste of Walden, and our first restaurant week. So that same week, April 29th through Tuesday through Saturday, we're having different restaurants offer specials, their choice. Many of them who are at the Taste of Walden will have that information for you there. But you could go into your favorite restaurant and ask them if they're participating in Restaurant Week. And if not, give them a nudge and tell them they should. And it's just giving everybody an opportunity to check the food scene in Walden, which is pretty exciting, I think, anyway. It's a great food destination. So that's April 29th for the Taste of Walden and that week for Restaurant Week. And then the next one coming up after that is going to be a combined Melrose Walden Chamber of Commerce. We're going to have it at Marty's Furniture. It's in May. It's going to be a great night, chance to network, exchange business cards, see old friends, make new friends, hear a wonderful speaker, have a little champagne. It's going to be offered that night. And again, just really network with each other to promote business. So that's kind of what's happening with the Chamber. And I'm going to move now on to our guests for the show. Our first guest tonight is Gabriella Schneider Stelmack from Bread of Life, Executive Director of the Bread of Life. And with you is probably your newest employee, Patty Kelly, who is Development Director. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you. How long have you been with Bread of Life?
Since 1988.
Long time.
Yeah, a long time.
I remember when you were on Main Street across from Florence in a little tiny storefront.
For 20 years we were there.
And you've moved.
Right.
So tell us where you are now, and I'm sure the numbers have only increased the need.
Yeah, we're at 54 Eastern Ave, so we moved in there renting in 2013, and then we bought it in 2014. So yes, people remembered when we were on Main Street, you know, we were just bursting at the seams. So Bread of Life started in 1980 as at St. Paul's Parish, right around the corner, as a church potluck, and it grew to accept anybody that needed food, because a few homeless guys walked in, and that church responded and said, "Well, we want to be able to serve whoever is in need." In those days, there were actually a lot of rooming houses in Walden, and people didn't have cooking facilities. Over the years, things have changed, and things have grown. Mm-hmm. So on Main Street, we ended up, you know, having to rent another storefront, 509, and then 507, and the pantry grew starting around 1995, so that now we serve a million meals, half of them going out through our food pantry, of groceries and a lot of fresh produce mainly, as well as meats, dairy, breads, So we really needed the room. And it's actually amazing to me when I think of it. So Bread of Life as a concept and an entity starting in 1980 has been around 39 years. And it's actually kind of amazing that we don't have a home because the need for food hasn't gone away.
Right.
The cost of living is very expensive in Malden and in the whole Boston area. Mm-hmm. And the people that we see just have a lot of trouble, whether they're working, retired, disabled, families with kids, having a lot of trouble making ends meet. Mm-hmm. And so we serve low-income people of every different background. And we need to ensure that for the future.
Yeah.
So we have a project to tear down our buildings at 54 Eastern. That was our original intention when we bought the place. It used to be Volpe, the home of Governor Volpe and his business, Volpe Construction.
Okay.
Did you know that?
I did not know that. No.
People sometimes still think of it and remember his high-end car. You could always tell when he was there, this car parked in front. But the front building was their original home of the family. And then the sort of an industrial building in the back that was his business place.
Yeah.
So we're sort of shoehorned into that. It was never designed for food. We have our pantry storage in there and our distribution. And we're still using donated and rented spaces for the meals. Mm-hmm. So our idea in our working with our architect and our developer is take down that, build a brand new building, state-of-the-art kitchen, walk-in fridges and freezers. And we're partnering with Metro North Housing Corp, a separate nonprofit that's going to own and operate 14 units of studio apartments that will be affordable for formerly homeless and veterans.
Nice. So I didn't know that. I knew about the plans for expansion. In fact, I think that's why you brought Patty in.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So, really, yes. You're new there.
I am new to the Bread of Life. I started February 4th.
Very good.
April, my three-month anniversary is coming up.
Wow. Gabby.
And how's it going, raising the $1.5 million?
We're doing okay. So we have a $2.9 million campaign that we are working toward, and we are 1.4, I believe, into it.
About half.
Yes, so we're halfway there.
A point of interest, our camera woman over here, our floor manager today, Dee Dee, it's D-I-T-I, she did a neighborhood view and wrote a story. She was telling me. Yep. She did the story about you and said you were just about halfway there.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you for the wonderful article, too.
It was great. Isn't that nice?
A lot of great feedback about that.
Yeah, good. Yeah. So, of course, you and I go way back in lots of other roles, especially the chamber.
Yes, we do.
Just past president.
Yes.
And now what are you
president
calling?
2017 and 2018.
Yeah, 2 years of presidency.
Now I guess I'm the immediate past president.
Immediate past,
that's what we say.
Yeah. And so here you are helping Gabriella raise funds to do this new build out.
Yes.
It's a challenge.
It is a challenge. It's very exciting because we know what's going to be coming, and it's so needed, as you said earlier. The need is growing, and we're really operating on very limited resources. Yeah. So to have this new building, not only for the Bread of Life, but we hope to have a community resource center inside the building as well to share with our partners and chamber friends and use it for trainings and hosting presentations there. That's part of the building as well.
That's great.
That's exciting, too.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but do you make meals or prepare meals for families that have been displaced and maybe staying in motels?
We still do.
We
have done that a number of times in our history. The most recent spate of the overcrowding of shelters was that we got involved in was in 2008, believe it or not. Mm. 10 years delivering prepared meals and groceries and baby supplies to up to 100 families at a time every week at motels. And then the state, you know, with a little more prosperity, had said a couple years ago, we could move all these people out of the motels. But we thought it was gonna end, and there are still families there. It's that, you know, that booming housing market is the downside of it is when people cannot afford it. The families that are unemployed at the moment, or the moms that are taking care of children. Mm-hmm. So yes, we're still serving three hotels and three. Sending every week food.
So I assume you need volunteers as well as contributors.
Always.
You
want to
you have a chance to speak to the public
fabulous.
Out there
and fabulous. I think the other thing that's interesting as well, you had mentioned the motel meals. We also work in collaboration with other entities in Malden. One is the Malden Teen Center.
Mm-hmm.
We work with them as well. We actually got invited to their Red Sox opening day last week, which was fun to see.
Oh,
and they had us for ice cream sundaes and hot dogs. And
there's
a lot of good energy in that building.
Good.
For
yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
But as far as volunteering, getting back to that, absolutely.
Yep.
As we said, Tuesday through Friday, we serve a meal. Right now, it's at the First Baptist Church in Melrose. Excuse me. I'm from Melrose. I think fondly of the Baptist Church. We were just there recently. But we do serve a meal there, Tuesday through Friday. And then we have the food pantry service, which is Wednesdays and Friday afternoon for folks to come. So there's always a need for volunteering to help put bags together for the pantry, serve the meal at the evening meal, donate a meal. Where any time a group can cook for us, that's one less thing that we have to pay for to do. So that's another way to volunteer as well. And also office help too. We can use that occasionally, particularly when we're doing mailings and things like that. We welcome people to come in and sit with us and address envelopes and stamp them and get them out the door for us.
So, you know, you can post that on the Chamber website when you have a particular, like the office thing I'm thinking of. The others are standard times for volunteers. But if you had a need and you let the Chamber know, call Joan, she'll put it out there on the Chamber Blast.
Absolutely.
And
the
you
Chamber's
might get some folks
resource.
Down there. It is a great resource. Well, you would know that.
Yes.
And one extra piece of interest for businesses, and we're proud members of the Chamber, as you know.
Sure.
It is a great chance to meet businesses, and of course we're in the food business, so different providers like Hoff's, Anthony's, Bobby C's, and I'm forgetting numerous, Cornucopia, have donate food to us, Comcast, that businesses should know if they'd like a project for their employees.
Okay.
We have groups like Encore Boston, Comcast, BNY that come in and donate a meal and bring the volunteers so they have their employees come in.
Okay.
And it's a great way for people to feel they're making an immediate difference.
Yeah, sure. So in the last minute that we have, why don't you just let us know, let the people know how to donate for your capital campaign.
Sure, thank you for the opportunity for that. Our website is www.breadoflifemalden.org. And it's a great resource not only to donate, but it also goes into detail about our capital campaign as well. So you can learn a lot more from that.
All right.
So thank you for having me.
I want to thank you both for coming. And you're on my bucket list to volunteer. You have been for a while.
Great. So I'd love to have you.
I would love to do that. All right. Thanks for coming. Good luck with the capital campaign.
Thank
you,
Lisa.
Keep feeding all those people.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back to for our second guest. We'll see you in a minute.
Thank you very much. you very much.
Welcome back to Chamber Showcase. I'm Lisa O'Loughlin, your host of the show, and with me is my second guest, Galvin Murphy.
Hey,
Galvin.
Thank you for having me.
Mr. Bugs, Bugman himself here.
Yes.
Yankee Pest. So let's briefly talk about Yankee Pest. What do you do?
Well, we do pest control, both residential, commercial, whatever people need, all types of pests, all types of rodents.
Critters.
Yeah, critters, and we'll get them out of their businesses and get them out of their homes.
Yeah. And you have a dog?
We do. We have Miss Layla.
Yeah.
She's quite good at going out there and finding bed bugs.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's big fear.
Yeah. Well, they're a nuisance, aren't they? I mean, they're not harmful, but they're pretty disgusting. When people get them, they get all
they get
agitated.
All nerved up.
Yeah,
some people call up very excited when they have a problem with bed bugs.
Yeah, sure. And they do go rampant around, don't they?
When they can. Yeah. They can, and you know, well, education goes a long way.
Yep.
You know, you're not going to get sick from them.
Right.
You just relax, and they can be taken care of.
Yeah. Well, you've certainly helped me out in my former company when I was doing home care services. We'd
mm-hmm.
have you many a times, and your education. I tried to educate my own staff so they wouldn't freak out if they thought they saw a bed bug. And it's a great service that you do.
Thank you.
As important as that is, more importantly, is your past role with the Chamber of Commerce. So how long has it been?
Oh, I wouldn't even be able to guess how long ago I joined the Chamber, and different levels of involvement at different times, being on the board to being on different committees, and
mm-hmm.
You know, business takes you away from that. You don't have the time, and
right.
certainly family is important to me, so
mm-hmm.
I can't always be there all the time, but I've had some good times with the Chamber over the years.
And you do other community things, like the toy drive at
Christmas
right.
is
so, huge.
Yeah, with my club Kiwanis and Housing Families, we collect toys and distribute them through the city through different programs. And try and make sure as many families that need some toys, and we do some meals at that time also,
mm-hmm.
and make sure everybody has a joyous holiday season.
Yeah. And you support veterans?
We do. We have different events that we do for veterans. One of my favorite ones these days is hiring veterans that are looking for work. It's always nice to bring a young veteran in and get them on the right track. A lot of times they're going to school and they need part-time work. We'll do things like that with
mm-hmm.
them. But it's important to always support our veterans and their families.
It is very important and very needed as well.
Mm-hmm.
So one of your many tasks as a chamber member was the Taste of Walden.
Right. That I can't believe it's been 10 years.
10 years. So you heard me say that
exciting.
Earlier. It's a 10-year anniversary. You were the first year. You were there at the beginning.
Right.
I didn't come in till the second year. But
mm-hmm.
So give us a quick history.
Well, it's funny. I happened to attend an event in Newton that was very similar to what we ended up doing here. And Ted Coates was our executive director
yeah.
at the time. And he met me one day and we're just talking. He said that he went to one in Chelsea. And I was giving my experiences that I had at the one in Newton. And I actually tried to get Kiwanis to get involved with doing something similar to that. But we had a lot of other events going on at the
mm-hmm.
time. So there was no interest in it. And Ted said, we should do one of those here in Walden. And I said, sign me up. I'm on board. And we went forward, we got a great group of people together, and we went out and we were able to hit up the restaurant owners in the city, and you know, the first year was very exciting to me. It kind of made sense that if we're gonna do something with food, we should bring the Bread of Life in. And we nailed it, we brought the Bread of Life in. We did it at the Jackson Suite, the
yeah.
old Jackson Suite, the garage down
yeah.
there. And the real problem we had that year, Lisa, was we couldn't fit everybody in.
Right.
I remember at one point I was in the offices at the Jackson Suite doing some work, and I was helping some of the restaurants carry some food in, and I noticed in the garage we had a line wrapped around. And I just went over and said, give me your tickets, you know, we'll get you through this thing here. And I was told very quickly, it's nothing to do with the line, it's just a matter of there's no place for people to go inside. We couldn't fit them in, so we had a great turnout, great event, a lot of fun, and
yeah.
We made some money for the Chamber. We exposed the restaurants to a lot of people. We exposed the Jackson Suite to people.
Yeah.
And we helped out the Bread of Life
Bread
that
of Life,
day.
Who were our first guests today.
Yeah, great people.
And they're doing a capital campaign. You heard them talk about that a little bit.
Right, and you know, Yankee Pest Control decided to get on board with that. And we're going to
okay.
have some type of event. We still need to work it out with Patty and Gabby. We're going to have some type of event at our building later this summer. We're going to invite all our friends to come and have something to eat. We'll set up some type of food there, and we'll have some entertainment, and we'll have Patty there shaking everybody down.
I was going to say, with her little can, you know, go around, right?
Well, I was going to set up a noose. We could tip people upside down and shake the money out of their pockets.
There you go.
One other event that, if I could, is that we've offered to the Bread of Life that any new customers will call us up at Yankee Pest Control for the rest of the season and says, you know, we're calling you because we support the Bread of Life. We'll make a generous donation for every new customer we get, $50 for every new customer we get for the rest of the year.
Really? Now, that's something we could put out of the chamber.
That, absolutely.
The newsletter, because there's a lot of businesses and individuals. I mean, I'm a customer.
You certainly are. Thank you.
I don't have any bugs. Well, actually, I do. I have carpenter bees.
Carpenter bees.
Oh, you come. Well, not you, but others. Yeah, they come for my carpenter bees. They're a bug.
You can always tell a carpenter bee from a regular bee. How do you do that?
No.
If you look at it, it has a brown stripe around the middle. That's his tool belt that he's carrying.
I was just going to say, something to do with wood. I was going to say, put wood out and honey out. I don't know, but that's the tool belt. So that's really good of you. You're a very generous guy, so that's really nice to support. So the Taste of Malden, every year, we always, no matter what event the Chamber does, we have a nonprofit that we make a contribution to.
Right.
So the Bread of Life has been one of our nonprofit partners in the past. This year we're doing the Malden Y food program. I'm not going to use the right words here, but for kids. In the summer, they don't go to school, you know, they're out of school. There's no hot breakfast, there's no hot lunch. So they go out to all the parks and put food out for them. And they've also started a food pantry so they can send their kids home with a backpack of food once a week on after their program. So they're our nonprofit this year. There's certainly plenty of nonprofits. They could all use some help.
We have some great nonprofits in the city.
Yes, we do.
We
also have some great restaurants in the city.
What's
the change? What do you see in the scene, the restaurant scene from your first year to?
Wow, it's changed dramatically. I mean, we get some great places. Not that we didn't in the past, but it just keeps improving. Which, you know, it's almost like a, not almost like it is a destination now to come to Malden. From all over the Boston area to hit some of our restaurants.
That's right. So the last two times I've bumped into you was both at a local restaurant.
Absolutely.
I see you in there. I'm like, oh, boy. So, and then we spoke about this taste coming up the 10 years and how I really wanted to get you on the show. So I don't know how many restaurants you may have had your first year. We've gone up a little bit. Now we've just come down just a little bit. I think we're between 18 and 22.
I think we're around 30-something the first year. We had to crisscross them in the facility that we had. And it was great. I mean, we went outside the city a little bit. We got some more people in there, but we were just looking for an exciting event.
Sure. And then we moved on to the Irish American. That's
the
where
Irish
I
American.
Got involved.
I mean, maybe a couple of years there.
Yeah.
Because I ran the program.
At least two
I was a chair for 3 years.
Yep.
So I think after that, we moved out someplace, and it was time for somebody else to step up and do their part.
Well, thank you very much. I have chaired it for several years, and then I actually retired and left the city for work anyway, and came back to work after 6 weeks of sitting home doing nothing. I kind of went crazy. So I came back and I said, the first thing I want to do is get back to the chamber. My new boss, I'm not the boss anymore. I have a boss. He agreed to let me not only join the chamber, but chair this and can continue back on the TV show here. So it gives me a great opportunity. I get to talk to guys like you and great people like Bread of Life and all of the other folks. Housing Families has been a guest. And we try to bring a business or two in every month. A new member, an old member. We encourage the networking. We really push to get people to come out to the networking events. We offer to buddy up with them. If you're a new member, we'll hook you up with someone who can go with you and introduce you around. And, you know, it's like the new kid at school. You just don't know what to do. So the Chamber really does try to support the businesses. And
they do a great job. You know, one of the things I'd like to do is really promote the taste. And really, if somebody's watching this and they're not aware what it is, it's a bunch of the local restaurants coming in, and you get to sample their food. And it's the opportunity that you always said, I want to try that restaurant, and you never do. This is the time to do it.
Yeah, it is. And I've done a whole show just on the taste for the past month. So, well, we're going to run out of time here. So I want to thank you for all of your past service to the Chamber, to the taste, to your veterans, to the toys, the Kiwanis, and all of that. You're just a great all-around guy.
Hey,
appreciate it very
much. Thank you
very
much, Lisa.
Thanks
appreciate
so much.
The opportunity to come in and see you.
Okay, so that's another show for the Chamber of Commerce, Chamber Showcase, and we hope to see you next month. But before that, I hope to see you at the Taste of Malden and Restaurant Week, which we didn't really talk about, our first Restaurant Week. So enjoy Malden, its restaurants, its food, its people, and we'll see you here next month. Have a good night. Thank you.